giving me an opportunity, I will be speaking on pollination of fruit crops in India. When we look at the productivity, it is 11.6 tons per hectare, very less as compared to other countries of the world. It is 23.3 tons per hectare in USA. Our exports to are less than 1% of the world trade. By 2020, India will be the most populous country in the world with a population of about 10 million. Hence, the strategy's requirements and to enrich the crop varieties with specific nutritional diversity. As you know, horticulture today is not merely a means of diversification, but has become an integral part of nutritional and economic security. Since nearly 30% of our population continues to suffer from malnutrition, in providing balanced diet, horticulture crops like fruits, vegetable, and medicinal plants play an important role. At present, the horticulture sector contributes about 30% to the agriculture GDP from about 14% of the area and 40% of total export earning in agriculture. However, the challenge is to be more than double the present production of fruits and vegetables from 377 million tons to 500 million tons by 2050. Per capita availability of vegetable and fruits, though improved over the last few years, is still below the recommended levels, and hence the nutritional health security can be achieved by enhancing productivity. Besides other factors, insect pollinators for improving productivity and quality of fruit crops are very important. Insect pollination is a necessary step for the production of fruits and vegetables grown throughout the world. 15% of the crops are pollinated by non-native domestic honeybees, and at least 80% of the crop are pollinated by wild bees and other wildlife. Yes. You see, more than 73% of the bees are involved in the pollination of crops, 19% flies, 6.5% bats, 5% wasps, 5% beetles, 4% birds, and 4% butterflies. Therefore, besides bee, there are other number of pollinators which are involved in the pollination services. Most of the fruit crops are self-incompatible and require not only pollinating insects but suitable pollinizers as well in pollination management. Most of the fruit crops are self-incompatible and require not only pollinating insects but suitable pollinizers as well in pollination management. Even the self-pollinated crops benefit tremendously by pollinated by bees. Having enough pollinator during bloom is essential to produce a sustainable crop. Proper pollination increases fruit size, fruit yield, hastens maturity, and produces a more symmetrical fruit shape. A well-pollinated flower will contain more seeds with an enhanced capacity to germinate, leading to bigger and better shaped fruit. Improved pollination can also reduce the time between flowering and fruit set, reducing the risk of exposing fruit to pests, diseases, and bad weather. Now, number of crops are dependent on pollinator bees. Fruit crops among tropics and subtropics include mango, banana, guava, papaya, pineapple, and citrus, grape, pomegranate, amla, pear, custard apple, fig, jackfruit, jammu, lychee, locust, avocado, date palm, and passion fruit. Among temperate fruits, we have apples, pear, peach, plum, almond, and cherries. And among vegetables, tomato, watermelon, muskmelon, pumpkin, squash, cold crops, carrot, bitter gourd, cucumber, radish, turnip, asparagus, brinjal, okra, lettuce, peppers, beans, field beans, and scarlet beans, etc. We see that most of the crops are dependent upon pollinating insects to a varying degree. In case of almonds, avocado, blueberry, broccoli, carrot, cauliflower, celery, and onion, they are 100% dependent upon bee pollination. In case of apples, asparagus, cherries, cucumber, pumpkin, they are dependent upon up to 90% on bee pollination. Apricot, plum, strawberry, 70% on bee pollination. Pear, 50%, watermelon, 40%, Brussels sprout, 30%, cabbage, 30%. Bean 10%, lettuce 10%. So in order to have an optimum production of crops, there is a need for pollination, and the dependence of the crop varies from one crop to another. Effective pollination period is most important and plays a clear role in controlling cropping in fruit trees. Consequently, it is a useful parameter to dissect and locate the factors limiting fruit set. Now, three main processes are important: stigmatic receptivity, pollen tube kinetics, and ovule development. Alterations in any of these events can seriously impact fruit production. Thus, lack of pollinating insects or vectors or bad weather prevailing during this pollination period makes the pollen transfer difficult. The situation is further complicated in incompatible species in which self-pollen tube growth in the style is impaired and adequate pollinator cultivars are required. If we see, different crops have different effective pollination period. It is compiled from different sources. In apple, it is 2 to 9 days. Pear, 1 to 10 days. Sweet cherry, 3 to 10 days. Apricot, 2 to 8 days. Peach, 7 to 10 days. Plum, 3 to 10 days. And kiwi, 3 to 4 days. So the pollination must happen during this effective period. Otherwise, there will be. Now, we have different type of pollinating insects, but the efficiency and the working capability of each pollinator varies. If we take the case of population size in honeybees, it is a remarkable. We have sufficient number of bees and can be placed in large number at our will as and when required. In case of solitary bees, the number is very small. In case of bumblebees, the number is very small. But pollination efficiency varies in each case. In honeybees, they have more thrust for collection of nectar as compared to the solitary bees. Because of their single nesting habits, they have more preference for pollen collection. Hence, the solitary bees prove to be the most effective pollinator and best pollinators. Even though their population is less, but their urge for more pollen collection is very useful for crop pollination. In case of bumblebees, they also have very this high foraging rates, twice than the honeybees. And one most important feature of bumblebees is they can work under extremely low temperature conditions, inclement conditions, at which no other pollinator is visible. Then pollen collection, this is carried comparatively less in honeybees than the solitary bees and bumblebees. Now, adherent bees carries more pollen loads on their body than honeybees. Solitary bees gather pollen loosely, adhering to their hairs on the ventral side, in contrast to the honeybees, which pack the moistened pollen into their carbicular. So, the solitary bees, they are more effective in affecting the pollination as compared to the honeybee. So, all this group of bees have different pollination efficiencies, but as compared to the honeybees, solitary bees and bumblebee prove to be the most effective pollinators. Now, no doubt their population is low, but if we encourage their conservation, increase in populations, they could prove the better pollinators. Further, the flower visit rates, they are fast in honeybees, slow in solitary bees, and very fast in bumblebee. Next slide, please. Bee pollinators of different crops in cucurbits, other than honeybees, squash bees, Paponapis, Prunisa, and Xenoglyssa strain are most important pollinators. Non-manage wild species, specialist on cucurbits, then fruit trees, orchard mason bee, Osmia ligneria. Population in orchards is augmented with commercially available larvae or with provision of nesting sites. Then in case of blueberry, orchard mason bees, Osmia riboflores, Osmia ligneria, Osmia chelivia, Osmia virga, they are the most important solitary bees affecting pollination, being studied and promoted as managed species. In southern blueberry bee, then there are bumblebees, which are important pollinators. Then eastern carpenter bees, Xylocopa virginica, mining are adherent bees, alpha alpha leaf cutting bee, megakyle rotunda. Then in case of dearberry, melitated bee, Melita americana, sonicates to collect and distribute pollen from daytime bees are the modern pollinator. Then there are leaf cutting bees, Megagyle addenda is the most important pollinator of the cranberry. Next slide. Some of these are exclusive. This bees, they include bumblebees, honeybees, bumblebees, sultry bees, and stingless bees. In soybean, honeybees, bumblebees, and fruit, sultry bees. In sesame, honeybees, sultry bees, and wasps. In safflower, honeybees, sultry bees. In papaya, honeybees, thrips, moths, and butterflies. In oil palm, this beavers, they are important pollinator. In mango, honeybees, sultry bees, and flies. In lemon, honeybees. In carrot, flies, sultry bees, honeybees, and cotton honeybees. And they contribute from 10 to 90% is the pollinator impact of these bees on these crops. Now, there are some plants, they are pollinated by bumblebees. In case of almond, apple, apricot, avocado, watermelon, blackberry, blueberry, cashew, cranberry, and cucumber have been reported to be pollinated by bumblebees. This guava, kiwi fruit, orange, passion fruit, peach, pear, plum, raspberry, strawberry, bumblebees play an important role in their pollination and fruit setting. Now, in case of vegetable crops, tomato, honeybees, wild bees, halected bees, bumblebees, and wild sultry bees, they are important pollinators. In watermelon, honeybees, bumblebees, and different species of bees, such as halected species, then some trigona species, they are important pollinators. In case of pumpkin, honeybees, wild bees, and in case of cucumber beetles, scrap beetles, mallet beetles, flies, and moths, they are important pollinators. In muskmelon, honeybees, ants, and thrips are important pollinators. In coal crops, honeybees, wild bees, and flies are important. In carrot, flies and bees, they are the most important pollinators. Bitter gourd, small bees. There are important non-apis bee pollinators which have been recorded on different crops in India. In orange and lemon, lesioglossum species. In case of orange and lemon, lesioglossum and xylocopa fenestrata has been reported as important. In guava, among sultry bees, xylocopa pubescens, xylocopa fenestrata, and Megagyle lanata has been reported as important pollinators. Mango, xylocopa species, Megagyle species, nomia species, and lesioglossum. In pomegranate, nomades, lesioglossum, halactus species have been reported. In case of apple, among the non-apis bee pollinators, there are coitus, lesioglossum, plum, acicarniferans. And then andrena species, bombus hemoradalis, halactus, bachali, osmia species, pithidus species, xylocopa fenestrata, and nomia species. In almond, lesioglossum and xylocopa valga. In cherry, xylocopa valga and nomia species. In pear, xylocopa valga and nomia species. In sweet potato, xylocopa fenestrata, bombus albo pluralis, and bombus asiaticus. In eggplant, bombus asiaticus, xylocopa fenestrata, amygdala delicata, amygdala sub casserulea, nomia species, califora, pithita species. In onions, onion nomidus species, lesioglossum, and xylocopa fenestrata. In radish, anthophora species, lesioglossum species. In pumpkins and squashes, xylocopa, xylocopa pubescens, xylocopa fenestrata, halactus, and nomidus have been reported as important pollinators. In smooth loofah, loofah azeptica, xylocopa fenestrata, xylocopa pubescens, and pithitus smaragdula has been reported as important non-apis bee pollinators. In cucumbers, nomia species, smaragdula, nomidus variegata have been reported. No doubt, wild and managed honeybees are well documented as effective pollinator of global crops. But still, there are some other pollinators than the bees, which include flies, beetles, flies, beetles, moths, butterflies, wasps, ants, birds and bats, among others, non-perform 25 to 50% of total number of flower visits. Although non-bees were less effective pollinator than bees per flower, they visit, they made more
Professor
visits,
Abrol, resulting Professor in increased Abrol, you have only success.
Independently of bee visitation rates, indicating that non-bee insects provide a unique benefit that is not provided by bees. Non-bee insects are not as like bees, but they play a significant role in global crop production and respond differently than bees to landscape structure. The honeybee Apis mellifera is the most versatile managed pollinator, but the global reliance on this single pollinator species is a risky strategy given major threats to the health of managed honeybee colony. Next slide. And in USA alone, more than 90 commercial crops, the honeybees have declined by 30% in the last 20 years. This has posed a great challenge to agriculture production. The number of colonies in US plummeted from 5.9 million in late 40s to 4.3 million in 85, 2.7 million in 1995, and 2.5 million in 2016. The loss of managed honeybee colonies signals one of the most severe declines in USA. And in the last 50 years, there are fewer bees than today. Population decline of honeybees in the world. In Germany, more than 57% of the bees have declined. In USA, 1%. USA, greater than 50%. Poland, more than 35%. India, more than 40%. Brazil, more than 53%. Netherlands, 58 to 65%. And China, more than 50%. So throughout the world, there is a decline in the number of bees. Now, what we can do? In concluding, pollination improve the most of the crop species and contribute fruit crop production. Honeybees are no doubt effective pollinator crops. However, the native bees are also important pollinators and in some cases are more efficient than the honeybees. By renting honeybee colonies with good pollination efficiency, a grower can compensate for the decrease in wild bees and increase in the likelihood of proper pollination. Depending upon the variety and conditions at the site, honeybee pollination may increase qualitative and quantitative characteristics of different fruit crops. Honeybees, as I told, are declining at an alarming rate. Conservation of wild bee pollinators holds a great promise. Further research and experiments may clearly give estimates of the economic value of pollinator services to the fruit crop. It is necessary to understand the importance of pollinator species richness in their natural habitat, and human activities must be subjected to their conservation. Now, conservation of clean and intensive cultivation has destroyed shelter locations of most of the wild pollinator. This has resulted in disappearance of native pollinator in many areas. Indiscriminate use of insecticide has resulted in devastating setback to non-target useful fauna, mainly pollinators and biocontrol agents. For increasing the number of native pollinators, development of habitat management programs has been suggested by many workers based on sound ecological principles. Further, there is a need for diversification of bee forage plants due to excessive monoculture, which can be achieved through plantation of multi-purpose flora under social and agroforestry programs. So artificial nesting sites have also been suggested for conservation and propagation of potential pollinators like bumblebees and elderly. Through targeted horticulture practices, stable population of pollinators can be sustained within urban areas. Now, for the conservation, nesting habitats of different bees are available. In case of Andrena, Pemigranus, Perdita, Pseudo, they are silent nesting bees. Conserving bees at natural landscape is good for itself. The best sites are bare or slightly vegetated, tender, silty loam. So by providing the nesting areas free from disturbance, we can conserve the bees. Similarly, colitis, elected they are soil nesting bees. And then APD,
Professor Abrol, Professor Abrol,
by providing artificial nesting sites, which consist of soda water straws, bamboo stems, castor stems, drilled boards, and pitchy materials. In anthropology,
they can also
be conserved the same way. In megagylid, water straws, bamboo stems, castor stems, drilled boards, they can be used for pollination. Next. But it is not the end of all crop pollination. Examples of greater efficiencies of orchard bees for palm fruit pollination, alfalfa leaf bees for alfalfa pollination, bumblebees for tomato and other solanaceous crop in greenhouses, blueberry bees for blueberries, and carpenter bees for passion fruit illustrate the examples where the solitary bees have an important role than the honeybees. The lack of pollination brought about by honeybees in oil palm, various anonymous fruit crops, red clover, and other crops with flowers with too deep for honeybees to work, and bad pollination
are even more extreme.
I shown examples of the need to consider alternate pollinator for many crops. The issue in the tropics are especially important because the natural pollination mechanisms are especially important because they are not understood.
Yeah, Professor Abrol, I'm sorry, but your time is up. So thank you.